on CRN Digital Talk Radio. I'm Jennifer Horn. Joining me, the trusty man who looks awfully confused right now that pushes all my buttons. I call him my DJ, M. Bizzle, Matt Bassant.
I don't know what happened to all the stuff in here. Everything was fine yesterday, and I come in today, and it's all torn apart.
That's the way it goes.
I don't understand it.
It's Radio 101. You leave, and everything is perfect. You come back, and it's like the raccoons have come through and torn everything up. You know, a lot of people blame Mercury in retrograde. Maybe that's what it is. I think Mercury in retrograde is coming to an end. You never know. All right, let's jump right into it. We are looking not only at the trends in news this week on the show, but also the trends in social media. Matt, that means you. Also the trends in social media.
There is, I don't know what happened. There's stuff.
Oh! There it is. This is what's called a cue. We had to give it twice. All right, the reason we're playing Fire, not just because it's a great song. This, I cannot believe, people do the craziest things for social media fame. Starting things off this week, a teenager has been hospitalized after he participated in the Fire Challenge. Apparently the cinnamon challenge where you swallow dry cinnamon wasn't just extreme enough. This kid in Florida, always in Florida, these guys, 15 years old, decided to try the fire challenge, which involves participants covering themselves in rubbing alcohol and then setting the alcohol on fire.
See, now, if there's one thing I've learned in life and my training as a fire explorer, fire burns.
Fire does burn. It's a great lesson, Matt. He willingly and voluntarily took part in this challenge. He asked one of his friends to ignite the rubbing alcohol. And this guy has no eyelashes today. He has third-degree burns. He has burns on his arm, on his back. He had to be airlifted to a hospital. His neck swelled up so badly, he is permanently damaged. And now the family, instead of blaming their stupid family member, they're blaming the friend that lit the match. Here's the deal. We've spent a lot of money to airlift anybody. You know these people are not going to pay for that. We pay for that. Us taxpayers pay for that airlifting to the hospital.
Well, of course we do. I think everyone should be blamed. All parties. Everyone.
And I'll tell you right now, the family, to blame this other kid, who, by the way, is not any better. I'm not saying he is completely... He should have said, no. No, friend. I'm not going to light you on fire. But, you know, to blame him. Crazy. Also going on this week... Facebook, instead of putting in the dislike button, which I am 100% in favor for because there are so many things I want to press dislike. Most of them involve all the dead animals people post on Facebook.
All of my posts.
All of your posts. They're going to now put emojis in that will be like hilarious, laughter, happiness, love, shock, sadness, anger. So we can't say dislike, but we can give you a little frowny face if we don't like
the
post.
I thought they did say they were going to add the dislike button.
Well, instead of the dislike, we're going to get emojis.
I just like that.
Emojis run the world.
Thumbs
all right, up ahead, we're going to jump into the biggest news stories this week involving, Congress. What's trending today on CRN Digital Talk Radio?
I am a non-attorney spokesperson. Attention men who've taken Androgel or any other testosterone therapy products. Androgel or other low-T products have been linked to heart attack, stroke, pulmonary embolism, deep vein thrombosis, even death. Scientific studies indicate that the use of testosterone therapy products may double a man's risk of heart attack. If you or a loved one took Androgel or a testosterone therapy product and suffered from a heart attack, stroke, pulmonary embolism, deep vein thrombosis, or any other cardiac event, you might be entitled to financial compensation. You have rights, and you need to let us fight for your rights. And you pay no fees unless we win. So call the tort attorneys right now. 800-557-7921. 800-557-7921. That's 800-557-7921. Cases may be referred to participating law firms in your jurisdiction.
Shake it up. It's what's trending today on CRN Digital Talk Radio. I am Jennifer Horn. And this show, if this is your first time tuning in, it takes all the biggest stories of the week, no matter what they are. They politics, sports, entertainment, even some food news, science, whatever it is, whatever's trending in any given week on social media and on the news, in the news cycle, we put it all together in one nice little package for you and present it to you in a show that we call What's Trending Today.
Or we at least try.
We try. All right. In my estimation, the biggest hard news, as we say in the business story this week, is the disaster that is the Speaker of the House position in Congress. John Boehner, amid a lot of pressure, and I actually think I may have put some on as well, decided that he would step down as Speaker of the House. He left Congress, and three people were going to run for that position. Kevin McCarthy, a Republican from California, Daniel Webster, and Jason Chaffetz from Utah. And Kevin McCarthy was by far the clear front runner, and this week there was a Republican caucus to kind of get it all together. They were only meeting with the Republicans to decide who that one candidate was going to be to present to the entire Congress to try to get the Speaker of the House confirmed. They needed 218 votes, which means that every Republican has to be on board except for 29. Their wiggle room is 29, so almost all the Republicans on board, because all the Democrats will naturally vote for their leader, the minority leader of the House, Nancy Pelosi. As of Thursday, when this caucus was taking place, Kevin McCarthy walked into the meeting going, "Hey, thumbs up, everybody. Everything's on schedule." This meeting was supposed to take all day. They were going to have Subway cater it. I mean, it was going to be a thing.
Yum.
Like 30 minutes later, out walks Kevin McCarthy with the announcement that, "You know what? This is just not my time." Now,
You're fired.
Yes. Many reasons for this, by the way. Donald Trump, one of them. Donald Trump actually taking a victory lap, saying he publicly said he didn't want Kevin McCarthy to be the next Speaker of the House, and that's why he's not. Many people say it was a gaffe that Kevin McCarthy made on the Sean Hannity program earlier in the week. He went on Sean Hannity's show and was talking about how people shouldn't be so quick to want to shut down the government over Planned Parenthood. Instead, they would form a select committee that would look into the happenings with Planned Parenthood, just as they did with Hillary Clinton in the Benghazi situation. And he made the comment, "Look where Hillary is now." Hillary Clinton grabs a hold of that and makes it seem like it was a witch hunt for her, which, hey, maybe it was, maybe it wasn't.
You know, everything seems like it's a bit of a witch hunt for Hillary.
Oh, yeah. She loves playing the victim, for sure. She's really good at that.
That's true.
So you have all these things going into it, but insiders are now saying that it had something to do with the gigantic skeleton in Kevin McCarthy's closet. Here's where it gets really House of Cards juicy.
Okay.
Apparently, somebody in North Carolina, I'm forgetting who now, somebody in North Carolina wrote a letter to Congress and said, to the Republicans in Congress, and said, "Look, we don't want any embarrassment here. Maybe we should look into the personal backgrounds of all the candidates that are interested in taking over the Speaker position."
You mean someone had a good idea in Congress?
Well,
wow.
That letter was sent. That letter was received. Now, on Wikipedia yesterday, are you following me so far? I'm trying to lay this out. All right. On Wikipedia yesterday, on the pages of both Kevin McCarthy and Congresswoman Renee Elmers out of North Carolina, a line was put in by a user of Wikipedia that the two were having an affair. Dun-da-da! We need better sound effects on this show.
Total disaster.
I need, you think,
it's
at least we have that. I need like dramatic
soap
opera music. But yes, it is a disaster.
Yeah.
Now, here's where it gets even juicier. Not only was this idea that he had an affair circulating, then we get a face with whom he is having an affair with, this Renee Elmers, North Carolina congresswoman, who's married, by the way, and has run on Christian family values. Oh, boy. Oh, boy.
Nothing ever changes with these people.
But when
Nothing.
Traced to see who posted this on Wikipedia, it was traced back to the Department of Homeland Security. What?
They can't even secure marriages.
So the question is the government out to get Kevin McCarthy? Does he have an enemy in the Department of Homeland Security? Was the Department of Homeland Security hacked? We don't know the answers, But we have a lot of stuff up in the air right now. I think it's fascinating. As someone who just loves politics, this, you can't ask. This stuff is writing itself. I mean, I'm a little dramatic here, but, you know, please. So now John Boehner stays, and the search is on for who is going to be the next replacement. Now, this is the sad part, and I'm a Republican. I make no bones about it. I'm a Republican. I'd like to see the success of the Republican Party, but you know what? Sadly, the people in Congress with the R's by their name are so dumb and stupid. They cannot get it together. There is chaos reigning supreme. They cannot get along. The Democrats, even though they have disagreements, they do it behind closed doors. The Republicans are like out there fighting all the time. And there is no one who seems to, there's not one person in all those people, all those hundreds of people in Congress that can actually represent someone that everybody's happy with, except for one man, I'd say two men. I think the biggest chance you have is Trey Gowdy and Paul Ryan. Paul Ryan, of course, the past vice presidential candidate with Mitt Romney 4 years ago. Now, John Boehner, the current speaker, has called Paul Ryan and begged him, Paul, please run. Paul Ryan's like, no, I'm on the Ways and Means Committee. I don't want to do this. He wants to run for the presidency. He's a handsome young guy, but he's got young kids. And as part of being the Speaker of the House, you have to do a lot of traveling. You have to do a lot of fundraising. He feels like this could hurt his family. So they're so desperate to get him in that maybe they would give him a term that says, hey, you know, you do this for a year, get us through the 2016 election. Maybe somebody else can travel for you. They're trying to find ways because they are desperate for Paul Ryan. And I can tell you, if Paul Ryan really does want to be the president, he will be the Speaker of the House. He'll make that announcement next week, I would imagine, because the Republicans need some glue. Now, you don't even have to be a member of Congress, by the way, to be the Speaker of the House. So you could draft somebody. Newt Gingrich. Remember Newt Gingrich?
Oh, yeah, the
neuter. He said, hey, John Boehner wants to leave at the end of October. I'll come in. I don't think that's a bad idea. Newt Gingrich worked very well with Bill Clinton back in the 90s.
I think one of my favorite presidents, Bill Clinton.
That's nice. I'm all for him. That's nice.
I'm all for him. Bring him back. Another year of Bill.
Bring out the cigars and the blue dress.
Bring
he actually wasn't bad. I'm going to say, of the Democratic presidency, not that bad.
Oh, good. You're like the only Republican that'll say that.
I'm honest.
Oh, yeah.
Now, the Democrats have put an ad on Craigslist as a joke to look for a Speaker of the House, which I thought was pretty funny. Also going on this week, those floods continued to ravage South Carolina. Really, really sad. Governor Haley said that she had toured the areas of Kingstree and Givens Ferry. It's very devastating. More flooding expected, even though there's sunshine out. The swollen rivers are expected to deliver more water to those low-lying coastal areas. So good thoughts still going out to South Carolina. And the weirdest story of the week, that train hero, remember Spencer Stone?
Yeah, I remember him, the guy from France.
Yeah, he thwarted that terrorist attack. Well, he was out in Sacramento this past week, and he got stabbed. And he got stabbed really badly.
From what I hear, that's pretty normal for Sacramento.
Really?
Yeah, I have a friend that lives up there. That's on the regular. It kind of sucks, man. You come back a hero and you get stabbed.
State capital. Those lawmakers pretty violent on their way home from the bars. But not really sure why he was stabbed. Two people are being sought after. We'll figure out more details as this one continues to unfold. Up next, oh, it's baseball finale, playoff time.
We got
the scoop for you. That's what's trending today.
Experiencing pain, back pain, shoulder, elbow, or hand pain, pain from a sports injury? If so, schedule a visit with Dr. Michael Sheps, the leading expert in laser therapy for pain management. Call 310-873-4422 or go to drsheps.com. Experience Epic T, the breakthrough laser therapy system that Dr. Sheps developed to make you pain-free in less time. Laser therapy is a non-invasive, safe, and effective in-office procedure that penetrates deep into your skin without damaging the tissue. It perfectly targets areas of pain to promote fast, natural healing. Relax your muscles, ease muscle spasms, joint stiffness, and arthritis pain while increasing blood circulation. For over 25 years, Dr. Sheps has helped Olympic athletes and sports enthusiasts alike get back in the game. Schedule your visit with Dr. Sheps at his Brentwood office in California. Call 310-873-4422 or visit drsheps.com. That's drsheps.com, 310-873-4422. Experience a luxury boutique hotel escape in the heart of Laguna Beach, California, with the finest art gallery, shopping, dining, and nightlife just steps from your door. The heart of Laguna Beach, the edge of the sea. It's the Inn at Laguna Beach. Enjoy our comfortable rooms, blending the style of a timeless beach bungalow with the modern comforts of today. 70 newly appointed guest rooms and suites await you at the Inn at Laguna Beach. Then, relax at the rooftop bar, where you'll indulge in breathtaking views of the ocean. For dining, you'll find libations and local cuisine on the California coastline, including dining at the legendary Las Brisas, a Southern California landmark. The Inn at Laguna Beach, footsteps from Rome to village to sea, located in the heart of Laguna Beach. The Inn is within walking distance of all that Laguna Beach has to offer. No car required. The Inn at Laguna Beach, 211 North Coast Highway in Laguna Beach, California. Call 800-544-4479 or visit innatlagunabeach.com.
What are you going to do with your old car? You can try selling it, you could junk it, or you could donate it to Heritage for the Blind. Your car will be towed away for free, and your donation is tax deductible. Just call 1-800-785-9618. Heritage for the Blind accepts cars, vans, trucks, and boats. It doesn't matter if your vehicle runs or not. It will be towed away for free, and you'll be supporting those that need help. Heritage for the Blind is a nonprofit organization that helps the visually impaired live fuller lives. Call right now to donate your car, and as a special thank you for calling, you'll receive a free 3-day vacation voucher to many exciting locations. Call Heritage for the Blind right now, 1-800-785-9618. Donating is easy, and your vehicle is towed away for free. Plus, you'll get a free vacation voucher. Call now, 1-800-785-9618. That's 1-800-785-9618.
You have my heart, and we'll never be worlds apart. Maybe in magazines, but you still be my star. Baby, cause
I'm just letting this one play, Matt.
You can't see shiny cars.
Cause I love this song. I don't love Rihanna much, but this song, oh, I love.
I'm right there with you.
I love it. All right, welcome back. It is What's Trending Today on CRN Digital Talk Radio. One thing you may not know about me is that I love sports. I'm one of those girls. And I'm not just one of those girls that like sports for boys. Like, I actually, like sports and, like, know stuff. Well, I don't know a lot of stuff.
You know more than I do.
I think I do, actually.
We're kind of like stereotype breaking here because you're the girl that likes sports and I'm the guy that couldn't care less.
You're the girl in our relationship.
I am the girl in the relationship.
Yeah, it's okay.
Have you seen my new shoes?
I'll bring you some flowers later. All right, so here's the deal. Baseball season has officially wrapped up. Now the postseason is starting to heat up. This week we had some wild card games and the Cubs, great news for the Cubs. And, you know, I'm a Dodger girl. Also like the Angels quite a bit. But I would say that the Cubs and the Mets are probably my next favorite teams in baseball. And the Cubs, just I'm kind of sadly pulling for them just a little until they play the Dodgers. Because the fans in Chicago have just, I mean, they've suffered forever. The last time the Cubs have won a World Series championship was in 1908.
Wow.
It's a huge drought.
Wow.
If you're playing at home, that's over 100 years.
Yeah.
So everybody was very happy that Chicago won the wild card. Also, a wild card matchup, the Yankees were involved with the wild card game with the Astros. And the way, I don't know if I like the fact the season comes down to one game, and then they decide who's going to be the big wild card winner. Now, the Yankees barely showed up. I mean, the Astros, who cannot stand. This is like a family thing for me. My grandmother hated the Astros. I hate the Astros.
So you were taught hate.
She called them a bad name. My grandmother, who was so sweet and never cussed, you can imagine what she called the Houston Astros. Just saying. But the Yankees had a tough week, and here's where we jump into it, into the good stuff. CC Sabathia, he is like their pitching ace. After the season ended, he made an announcement that he was checking himself into rehab before the wild card game. I would fire this guy so fast. Here, your team needs you, and you check into rehab. But I was thinking to myself, okay, I'd fire this guy. He sucks. He's selfish. Then I thought, he must have been really hammered. Because what? You have to be really hammered to drop out of your, like, your last game where the wild card is at stake. And guess what? I was right. He was really hammered.
That sounds like a scotch or tequila night right there.
He was really hammered. And here's what happened. And so now the reports are coming out about the real story. He went into rehab saying, it hurts me deeply to do this now, but I owe it to myself and to my family to get myself right. I want to take control of my disease. I want to be a better man, father, and player. Blah, blah, blah. Mm-hmm. You were hammered. Mm-hmm. That's what I would say. Reports are coming out that he had a huge weekend of heavy drinking in Baltimore. And the Yankees finished the season with 3 games on the road against the Orioles. Sabathia was not scheduled to pitch. The last straw for him came during the team's final regular season series in Baltimore, where he spent most of his time pounding drinks at a hotel. By Friday, he looked out of it. His team waited around a Camden Yard to play the game, which eventually was rained out. He drank every day last week, and apart from the day he pitched. The tipping point was Friday when he was at the stadium. He carried on drinking Saturday. It even spilled into the clubhouse at some point during the weekend as well. And he failed to respond to greetings of reporters who have known him a long time. He was walking unsteadily as he left the clubhouse. They said that Sabathia was offering a paper cup containing a brown liquid to a teammate who was finishing up a workout, urging the teammate to just take a sip.
I wonder what was in it.
The teammate refused, saying he still had some running to do. Sabathia was then ushered out of the building to a waiting cab by a third teammate. Joe Girardi said, I know players drink. That happens in the game. Adults have a drink, but he was not aware that it was at that level. It's become very severe. So this makes sense now. The only reason you drop out on your team is when the team kicks you out. And that's, it seems like, what happened to CC Sabathia.
And like you said, it must have been really bad for him to just up and do it.
Oh, had to be terrible. Now, not Rupert Murdoch. We're not going to talk about that. We're going to talk about Victor Cruz here in a second because this story is also juicy. We'll continue on our sports segment. But if you're paying attention, the division series kickoff now, this weekend, they'll be played. The Dodgers face the Mets. Watch out, Mets. I liked you up until you played the Dodgers. Now it's on. Now it's on.
You know, I don't think I can get behind the Dodgers. I never really could. I'm like, okay, they're there. I'm more of an Angels guy. I don't know why.
I bleed blue. I grew up with the Dodgers.
That sounds like a health condition. You might want to go to the doctor.
Royals facing the Astros. Blue Jays taking on the Rangers. So it'll be fun. It'll be fun to see where it all shakes out. Some new faces other than the St. Louis Cardinals who will face the Cubs. Ugh. Go Cubbies. Beat those Cardinals. All right. Up next, the story of Victor Cruz and celebrity news. It's what's trending today on CRN Digital Talk Radio.
Do you have really pure water? Maybe not if you're drinking bottled water. Bottled water has some dirty little secrets. Plastic bottles come from oil products. The 5-gallon polycarbonate jugs contain bisphenol A, a synthetic estrogen that has raised health concerns. Bottled water dispensers quickly develop algae and bacteria and should be sanitized regularly. Have you ever cleaned your water dispenser? Are you drinking water containing algae and bacteria and synthetic estrogen? Now the good news. Pure Water Science can replace that dirty, outdated bottled water cooler with a high-tech water purification system. The Pure Water Science system features a stainless steel tank that constantly monitors water quality to guarantee your water is pure. It alerts you when service or filter changes are needed. Multi-stage purification removes organic and inorganic contaminants, and the patented self-sanitizing feature eliminates algae and bacteria while adding oxygen to your water. It costs less than bottled water without the bottled water hassle. No more bottles to lift. Just sanitize delicious water, hot or cold, from Pure Water Science. Call 818-502-4191. 818-502-4191.
When you really want Italian food, you've got to go to Columbo's. Columbo's Italian Steakhouse and Jazz Club, Colorado Boulevard, Eagle Rock. It's that little neighborhood place you wish was down the street from you. Good afternoon, Mr. Phelps. Southern California is inundated with restaurants vying to vanquish Columbo's, and none have succeeded. Your mission, Jim, is to further enlighten the populace regarding Columbo's and their absolutely delicious steaks. Seafood so fresh it'll make you blush. Family Italian specialties that put the competition to shame. Jazz every night along with their world-renowned meatballs. The code words for this assignment, Mission Impossible Jewel. As always, should you or any other force be caught, the Secretary will disavow any knowledge of your actions, but looks forward to seeing you at that little neighborhood place you wish was down the street from you, Columbo's. This disc will self-destruct in 5 seconds. Good luck, Jim, and... Manja!
Experience a luxury boutique hotel escape in the heart of Laguna Beach, California, with the finest art gallery, shopping, dining, and nightlife just steps from your door. The heart of Laguna Beach, the edge of the sea. It's the Inn at Laguna Beach. Enjoy our comfortable rooms, blending the style of a timeless beach bungalow with the modern comforts of today. 70 newly appointed guest rooms and suites await you at the Inn at Laguna Beach. Then, relax at the rooftop bar, where you'll indulge in breathtaking views of the ocean. For dining, you'll find libations and local cuisine on the California coastline, including dining at the legendary Las Brisas, a Southern California landmark. The Inn at Laguna Beach, footsteps from Rome to village to sea, located in the heart of Laguna Beach. The Inn is within walking distance of all that Laguna Beach has to offer. No car required. The Inn at Laguna Beach, 211 North Coast Highway in Laguna Beach, California. Call 800-544-4479 or visit innatlagunabeach.com.
Andro 400, I really love it. I've lost 50 pounds. I was a size 38 waist. I've gone down to a 32 waist. My mood has changed. I don't get stressed out. It gave me so much more energy. It feels like I'm 25. I'm so happy. I'm just a completely different man.
Guys, if you'd like to see results like Dave Ryan's, try Andro 400, the safe, inexpensive way to boost your testosterone. Go to andro400.com or call 888-400-0435. 888-400-0435.
The Doug Steffen Good Day Program, early morning radio, and I guess it is radio, although it's radio on TV because this is CRN Digital Talk. You can find out what's going on in the world. We talk about the issues of the day, the events of the day, the people that people are talking about. We have an interesting way of looking at the news and having a little fun with the issues. So if you want to have some fun, learn a few things, and get up on the right side of the world, Doug Steffen's Good Day Program, weekday mornings, 2 to 7 a.m. on CRN Digital Talk.
It's what's trending today on CRN Digital Talk Radio. Jennifer Horn, Matt Besant's pressing all the buttons, and Victor Cruz in the news. You know who Victor Cruz is, Maddie Matt?
Cruz in USA?
New. Victor Cruz is a football player for the New York Giants, and he had, I'm not sure what the proper term is here, a fiance, Elena Whatley. This week, and this story blew up on social media, she sent a group text to every single one of the Victor Cruz mistresses.
Oh, no.
There was a photo that was leaked on Media Takeout that shows a screenshot of a text sent by Elena Whatley, and she sent it to not only Victor Cruz, but also a whole gaggle of his side chicks. I'm going to try to read this to you.
Okay, go ahead.
Hello, ladies. This is Elena, Victor Cruz's fiance. Very poor punctuation, by the way.
Okay.
I didn't have any comments. You all know about me, and I seem to be the topic of conversations with Vic. I'm sure he's told you many of the things about us and how we don't exist. But given the fact that you all meet him in hotel rooms only, we all know that's a lie. Just as he tells me you are all the H word. Well, the W-H-O-R-E-S word.
Okay.
And mean nothing to him. Now, it goes on. I figured since you all know about me, then I should introduce each one of you to each other so we can all know who we've all been blanking for the past several months. So, ladies, meet one another and feel free to exchange notes.
In his head, I just hear this.
Oh, my God, no.
Oh, no.
You know, I don't know. There's so many things about this I don't understand.
Nope.
I understand men will get away with men can get away with. I don't know that I understand Elena Whatley. And here's why. You know what happens when you date an athlete or you marry an athlete. You know what happens. You better have a lot of trust with that person to make it work, right? And then you also better be like, you know what? If he is going to be screwing around, that's his problem. I'm just going to walk away. You know she's never going to walk away because she's living the life. She's going to stay with him. He's going to be frightened of her. They're going to have the world's worst relationship. And it just doesn't make any sense.
you know, if I married someone who was making a lot of money, I more than likely would not care.
What, you as a woman? See, I
care. As a dude, I more than likely would not care.
Oh, you wouldn't care about what?
If my way was getting paid, I would not care at all. Go ahead, sleep with whoever you want.
I would have a problem with that, but I would walk away. Like, if I found this out, I'd be like, you know what? You blew it. You don't get to be with me anymore. And I would walk away. I wouldn't, like, send this text message, have it go viral on Twitter, and then you know she's going to stay. I just know it. I just know she's going to stay with him.
Of course she is. You know why?
Because she likes the lifestyle.
Because it's all about that bling, man.
Ugh,
jing, gosh. Jing.
All right, speaking of
pay my way.
Bad relationships, Bill Cosby.
Oh, my God, no.
Oh, no.
The network that made Bill Cosby is now going to break him. NBC News is going to interview 27 of the 50 women that have accused Bill Cosby of drugging and raping them. It's the first time this many accusers have been in the same room telling similar stories of assault. It airs Friday, so this weekend you'll be able to check it out. The Cosby Accusers Speak. It'll be hosted by Kate Snow as part of the Dateline show. And Cosby's 78. Now, you know what? He's actually really in danger of having charges filed against him. This woman from the Playboy Mansion that said she woke up to him sucking her toes. That's like a fever dream. Oh, Bill Cosby sucking on my big toe. My big piggy. There's real chance that he could get charges thrown.
Yeah, definitely.
But still, for some reason, even though he's so gross, it still makes me really sad. All right, Nick Gordon also in legal trouble. He is the boyfriend, or actually, I think, you know, they never got married. The boyfriend of Bobby Christina, who is Whitney Houston's daughter. She died after being in a coma for 6 months. Mm. She's very suspicious. She ended up in the bathtub just like her mother. People thought it was an overdose. Well, no. Now it looks like maybe he had something to do with it. He's fighting it, but it looks like there could be some murder charges thrown at Nick Gordon.
Wow, there's legal action all around today, isn't there?
John Stamos, have you heard about
that? No, there's another one. Yeah, I have.
John Stamos, by the way. Yeah, Uncle Jesse. He has a new show out called Grandfathered, which I watch. It's pretty cute. He got pulled over for DUI and went straight to the hospital a few months ago.
Mm-hmm.
Well, and then he went to rehab.
By the way, how loaded do you have to be pulled over and then the cops just immediately take you to the hospital?
He wasn't even drunk. He was on GHB, which is the date rape drug. Hold on.
Okay.
Attention, John Stamos. You don't give yourself the date rape drug.
Was he hanging out with Bill Cosby?
That is all. You don't give yourself the date rape drug. You should be easy pickings for yourself.
Hey, I don't know who that guy in the mirror is, but he's hot.
Well, he was taking it for workout purposes, he said. I guess this is something that helps lean you out, and he had this new TV show starting, so he's trying to lose weight. It also helps you sleep, obviously.
I'm sure it does.
You're roofying yourself. And so he had a lot of it in his system. That's why he was sent to the hospital. So that was what his deal was. Now, the Rock Hall of Fame announced some new inductees, or some new nominees. They do the nominations, and then they do the inductions. The nominations for this year's class of 2016 are Chicago, Cheap Trick, Deep Purple, The Cars, Janet Jackson, NWA, Nine Inch Nails, The Smiths, and Yes. That's Bill Cosby's favorite band. The rest of the year's hopefuls, Chaka Khan, Chic, The JBs, I don't even know who they are.
I don't know them
Los
either.
Lobos, the Steve Miller Band, and the Spinners. Pretty boring. I mean, I like Janet Jackson.
The first few you listed off, I'm
Chicago,
surprised.
Cheap Trick,
They should have been in there. Those are classic. They're staples in the medium. I don't know why they're not in there. But
NWA is pretty in fashion right now, too. I can't say I'd put them in my Hall of Fame, but they've been in fashion.
But for some reason, like the legal system, the Rock Hall of Fame just seems to turn so slowly that bands that you would think are in there or not.
What about Los Lobos? Like,
what?
A little La Bamba action. Anyway, the actual winners from this group of nominees will be presented in December. They'll be inducted into the Hall of Fame in April at a ceremony in New York. HBO covers it. And good news, I guess if you are a Voice fan and you don't want to see Blake Shelton and Gwen Stefani flirt anymore, like me, Christina Aguilera is coming back. Next season, she'll be back for season number 10. Yeah.
She's the best on that show.
Really? I can't stand her. I think she's never won. Anyway, love Blake and Adam. Come on. All right, up next, big problems with the new Black Whopper. Tell you what they are if you haven't heard. It's what's trending today on CRN.
Your local pharmacist is also a Health Mart pharmacist. They're not like other pharmacists.
After Mom's surgery, I was overwhelmed, but I was so relieved. Her Health Mart pharmacist was there to help. They explained her medication and even delivered to her house. Mom got the personal service she needed, and I got something even better. Peace of mind.
Visit healthmart.com to find a locally owned Health Mart pharmacy near you. Health Mart, caring for you and about you.
If you haven't seen Lumber Liquidators' incredible fall flooring deals, now is the time. It's the final days to save as much as 45% or more on all the latest hardwood trends. And it's your last chance to get $1 off select styles of premium Bellawood. Save 20% on stylish woodlook tile. And get coupon savings on quality Dream Home laminate with pad included. Plus, more deals from 59 cents and 15-month special financing.
This is Ty Pence. Go to LumberLiquidators.com/weekdays for a chance to win $4,000 in flooring from Lumber Liquidators.
Sales going on now. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
What are you going to do with your old car? You can try selling it, you could junk it, or you could donate it to Heritage for the Blind. Your car will be towed away for free, and your donation is tax deductible. Just call 1-800-785-9618. Heritage for the Blind accepts cars, vans, trucks, and boats. It doesn't matter if your vehicle runs or not. It will be towed away for free, and you'll be supporting those that need help. Heritage for the Blind is a nonprofit organization that helps the visually impaired live fuller lives. Call right now to donate your car, and as a special thank you for calling, you'll receive a free 3-day vacation voucher to many exciting locations. Call Heritage for the Blind right now, 1-800-785-9618. Donating is easy, and your vehicle is towed away for free. Plus, you'll get a free vacation voucher. Call now, 1-800-785-9618. That's 1-800-785-9618.
First things first, I'm the realest, realest. Drop this and let the whole world feel it. Let them feel it. And I'm still in the murder business. I can hold you down like I'm giving lessons in physics. Right, right. You should want a bad bitch like this. Huh? Drop it low and pick it up just like this. Yeah. Cup of Ace, cup of Goose, cup of Crisp. I heal something worth a half a ticket on my wrist. On my wrist. Taking all the liquor straight. Never chase that.
Now this is what's trending today on CRN Digital Talk Radio. I'm Jennifer Horn. All right, I can't say that I could tell you that fast food is ever really a great idea for you. That would be irresponsible with my high position in the media business.
I'll tell you it's great for you.
You know, sometimes in a pinch. Well, Burger King has put out, and it was a big thing on social media, has put out this black Halloween Whopper.
It doesn't look very good, but I've been hearing stirrings that it is actually delicious.
It looks horrible. It's a black bun. It looks like something that I would have dropped in my car while I was on the fly.
And forgot about it.
And forgot about. Well, apparently, when you eat the black Whopper, your poop turns neon green. I don't know how else to say it. Do we want to call it excrement? Would that make it a classier program?
Call it poop. Just call it poop. So call it what it is.
This is the big deal. So everybody was all excited when Burger King released the Halloween Whopper. They were going out. They saw the picture on Facebook. It looked kind of cool. The bun is actually tinted with A1 steak sauce.
I thought it was tinted with like a really dark green dye.
Probably that, but they say steak sauce to make it sound. There's probably like a drop of steak sauce and the rest is probably dye.
That would make it good.
Well, people were going out. They were curious. They ordered this black bun Whopper. And they go to the bathroom and the panic set in when out popped stripes of neon green. Mike Wycliffe. By the way, Mike Wycliffe from Indianapolis described it almost a grass green, which I thank him for. It's better to have vivid.
Oh, my.
Yeah. Well, there are many times where, I don't even know what to say here. There are many times when there is trauma in the bathroom. I don't know if you've ever maybe had asparagus, and you're like, yeah. Oh, my God, something's wrong with me. And then you're like, oh, yeah. No, I yeah. just had asparagus.
Or my favorite, too much red wine.
That can be a problem.
Oh, yeah.
Beets. Ooh, beets. In fact, we had a sponsor on the Doug Stevens Show called Super Beets, and there was a little bit of disturbance when I took it for the first time. One time,
This is probably too much information. As a little kid, I would bake with my grandmother often.
Okay.
And she would always make her frosting. Sure. She was already making her, she always make her frosting. Now, when I would bake with my mom, who was a busy working woman, she would buy the tubes of the frosting that were like bright red. So, you know, when you make your own frosting, everything's pink.
Yeah.
When you buy that frosting with the tulip on it at the, in the tube at the store, mm-hmm. it's a bright red.
Yeah.
And I was sneaking little sucks off the old frosting tube. I remember being like 5 or 6 years old and having a little poop moment, looking in the toilet and going, "Mom! It was bright red." I thought I was dying. And she goes, "How much frosting did you eat?" Thank God she knew. It's horrible. Anyway, warning, if you choose to eat this black Whopper, could be serious,
you know,
ramifications
I
later
think
on.
I know I'm going to have for lunch.
Challenge accepted.
Done and done.
Will you tell me? Will you report back?
I will totally report back.
All right, this story made me laugh. It was trending on Facebook this morning. One third of vegetarians eat meat when they get drunk. I get annoyed by vegetarians. I shouldn't be. I should probably convert to vegetarianism, but I get annoyed because, oh, I can't eat that. I can't eat that. Well, you can't eat that until you start drinking the wine, because after one too many cocktails, apparently people let their morals slip just a little bit. There is the majority of respondents to this poll at Voucher Codes Pro, 1,789 Brits took the poll, said that they stood by their personal dietary codes no matter how much they drink. But 34% said that every time they get drunk on a night out, they eat meat. Every time. 26% said that they eat meat fairly often. 22% said rarely. And 18% occasionally. So here's the tip. If you're annoyed like vegetarians, by vegetarians, take them out to the bar. Then take them to, like, a pizza place and show them, like, pepperoni and sausage pizza. I guarantee you, done deal.
I had a running joke with my ex that I won't say.
Something about sausage, I'm
Something
sure.
about sausage.
All right. Also going on this week, this one was on Twitter. An Ohio man called the police. He called a 911 dispatcher and said he was too high on marijuana. When officers arrived at his home in Austintown, they found him on the floor in a fetal position amid a plethora of Doritos, Chips Ahoy, and Pepperidge Farms goldfish. 22 years
the
old,
favorite food of stuffing.
Surrounded by junk food in the fetal position. Time to get off the old drug affair. In what could be the worst news of the week, there's a canned pumpkin shortage. Now, I'm a confirmed hashtag pumpkin
you
hag.
You and executive producer Courtney.
That's my girlfriend Courtney here.
Your girlfriend Courtney, total pumpkin hags, the both of you. Oh, my God. I've never seen anything like it.
Pumpkin. We love it. We love it. Well, now they're saying, and I think they threaten us with this so that they can raise the prices. They say the pumpkin yield could be off by a third this year. There's a shortage of canned pumpkin, and so if you want it, experts are saying don't wait until just before Thanksgiving to buy the canned pumpkin. Get it ahead of time. That's the big thing. And bad news if you like Girl Scouts. Well, not Girl Scouts. There's no bad news.
You might want to rephrase that.
Girl Scout cookies.
Try again.
Price raise again. Now those little boxes, which contain like four cookies, are going to be sold for $5 a box.
That's still not bad. I mean, if you got the munchies like the stoner dude with the Doritos and crap, I mean, yeah, $5 is nothing.
It's a lot of money for 12 cookies.
But still.
And all-day breakfast at McDonald's started. Don't know if you took
part. Oh, my God, yes. I am so down for this. And in fact, the first day it happened, Nikki bought me hash browns. I was all over it.
Hash browns with your chicken McNuggets.
Mm-hmm.
Dream.
Oh, my God.
That's what's trending today on CRN Digital Talk Radio.
Get in my mouth.
Experience a luxury boutique hotel escape in the heart of Laguna Beach, California, with the finest art gallery, shopping, dining, and nightlife just steps from your door. The heart of Laguna Beach, the edge of the sea. It's the Inn at Laguna Beach. Enjoy our comfortable rooms, blending the style of a timeless beach bungalow with the modern comforts of today. 70 newly appointed guest rooms and suites await you at the Inn at Laguna Beach. Then, relax at the rooftop bar, where you'll indulge in breathtaking views of the ocean. For dining, you'll find libations and local cuisine on the California coastline, including dining at the legendary Las Brisas, a Southern California landmark. The Inn at Laguna Beach. Footsteps from room to village to sea, located in the heart of Laguna Beach. The Inn is within walking distance of all that Laguna Beach has to offer. No car required. The Inn at Laguna Beach. 211 North Coast Highway in Laguna Beach, California. Call 800-544-4479 or visit innatlagunabeach.com.
Are you worried about losing your home to foreclosure? If you've been threatened with foreclosure or receive legal papers from your bank, you have approximately 30 days to respond. If you do not respond, you could lose your home. You have rights. Act now to protect your rights. You can stay in your home. Many times you can even modify your loan. The bottom line is you can get past this, but you must act right now. If you've been served by your bank and you're worried about losing your home to foreclosure, now is the time to fight back and save your home. Time is limited, so call the professionals at National Foreclosure Defense right now.
800-515-6309. 800-515-6309. 800-515-6309. 800-515-6309. That number again is 800-515-6309.
Do you have really pure water? Maybe not if you're drinking bottled water. Bottled water has some dirty little secrets. Plastic bottles come from oil products. The 5-gallon polycarbonate jugs contain bisphenol A, a synthetic estrogen that has raised health concerns. Bottled water dispensers quickly develop algae and bacteria and should be sanitized regularly. Have you ever cleaned your water dispenser? Are you drinking water containing algae and bacteria and synthetic estrogen? Now the good news. Pure Water Science can replace that dirty, outdated bottled water cooler with a high-tech water purification system. The Pure Water Science system features a stainless steel tank that constantly monitors water quality to guarantee your water is pure. It alerts you when service or filter changes are needed. Multi-stage purification removes organic and inorganic contaminants, and the patented self-sanitizing feature eliminates algae and bacteria while adding oxygen to your water. It costs less than bottled water without the bottled water hassle. No more bottles to lift. Just sanitize delicious water, hot or cold, from Pure Water Science. Call 818-502-4191. 818-502-4191.
A little inside baseball here at the CRM Broadcast Center. Our building is beginning renovations, and there's a nice grinding sound that is actually slipping through this unbelievably soundproof studio. If you can hear it, will you tweet me and let me know? Twitter.com at Jennifer Horn. Just say, it's grinding over here. I'll know what you mean. I don't know if you can hear it or not, so that's why I'm asking. I can hear a little bits of it.
I thought that was Paul and Jose trying to, like, renovate the other office. Like, I'm wrestling? Like, guys, you got to wait a little bit. And then they're like, oh, no, it's not us. Oh, no, I know what it is. We can't stop that one.
This is going to be a lot of fun, all I can say. Hope the cockroaches stay where they're supposed to be. All right, finally today, a couple of big stories. Netflix.
Oh, my favorite.
Raising their prices. And they're getting a lot of attention for this on
really?
Facebook today. Netflix is now raising their subscription rate by $1 a month, so $12 a year. They're going up to $9.99 for new customers. So if you don't have Netflix, you're thinking about signing up, the new rate will be $9.99. They're giving existing customers a grace period of varying lengths before the price actually goes up. The increase affects a plan that lets two viewers use a subscription at once. And prices for the one-screen and four-screen plans aren't affected. So this is if you have the two-person viewing plan. This platform, by the way, has 65 million subscribers worldwide. Netflix is huge.
Yeah, and I'm one of them, and I'm starting to think because our tech genius guru, Eric Hines, turned me on to an alternative.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm thinking of just going with that instead of Netflix. I mean, I'm kind of opting out of it now.
Well, you know, I like it because I can watch House of Cards there, but that's, you know, other than that, there are plenty of sources. Yeah. Now, this story I think is really cool. Scientists are getting closer to creating a real-life invisibility cloak.
This is awesome.
Uh-huh. A new study published in the Journal of Science show that scientists have created what they're calling an ultra-thin invisibility skin cloak for visible light, which, when it covers an object, by manipulating certain wavelengths of light, render that object invisible. So this is all playing off of light. This is scary for one reason, And that is, what is war going to look like now if everybody is invisible?
Well, here's the thing with these so-called invisibility cloaks, in that they're not true, and the ones that have been made have never been true invisibility cloaks, because you can always see an outline, especially if the object is moving.
Right, you can touch it or see it, yeah.
You can see it moving, because it, you would have to literally not be there for it to be true invisibility.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I mean, it's you'll still see them, but it'd be harder to see them from farther away.
What would be your superhero story? If, like, you could get a superpower, because this story made me think, okay, would I want to be invisible? And the answer is nobody puts baby in the corner. I would rather fly, I think, if you could have a superhero thing.
I would like telepathy.
You would?
Yes.
Why?
Here's why. Because not only can I, if I could move objects with my mind, I could also move myself and fly.
here comes that black whopper flying through the air. I don't know. I think flying would be better. I don't want to read somebody's mind, because you know what? People have terrible thoughts. I know what I think, and I wouldn't want anybody in there reading anything. I wouldn't want to do that to anybody else.
Yeah,
and invisibility, you know what? Sometimes you're just not meant to know things.
I don't think I would want invisibility. It seems like a pain. I'll pass.
And before we get out of here, sad passing, a friend of ours here at CRN, Paul Prudhomme. He was the celebrity chef out of New Orleans. He had the restaurant K. Paul's, and just an amazingly gifted chef, very creative. And if you could put charisma in a bottle.
Yeah.
Paul Prudhomme had it. He passed away this week at 75. He had hot sauces and spice mixes and cookbooks and did a TV show. He had multiple restaurants and just a really, truly nice, nice man.
And that's what our very own Les Kincaid was saying on yesterday's broadcast. Just nothing but nice things. Very dear friend, and he was very torn up about it. About
yeah.
The news. So.
So our thoughts and prayers go to his family, and Chef Paul Prudhomme will be missed for sure. All right, that's going to do it for us. Thank you so much, Matt Besson. Thank you, Courtney Cadera. And don't forget, you can check out podcasts of our show, all of our past shows at crntalk.com/ What's Trending Today. Enjoying all your favorite CRN programming is easier than ever. It's right on your TV, through your local cable provider, and on the web at crntalk.com. But when you're on the move, stuck in a plane, train, or in your car, catch up on all the shows you missed, or listen live to your favorites. Download our CRN app from your iPhone, iPad, Android, or BlackBerry. Just search for CRN Digital Talk Radio. Or search for your favorite CRN shows on apps like iTunes, iHeartRadio,